most patients with cardiovascular disease, if they've had an event, a heart attack or whatever, they're usually started on a high dose, atorvastatin 80 milligrams in hospital, and then GPs take over. So I think most of our patients with cardiovascular disease are on a statin, but there are some who don't want to take it, so they decline statins, some who are intolerant of statins and may be on ezetimibe alone. I think COVID has meant that, you know, we probably haven't done that as well as we should for many good reasons over the last year. So we've got a lot of work to do to review these patients and then to see if they're at target. And that's the other issue I think we have sometimes, is that not every GP sets a target and is strict about that target. Despite being even on high dose statins plus or minus ezetimibe, many patients don't get to the target LDL in particular, or total cholesterol. And despite the fact that there are patients who are on these, they are sitting out there with a very high LDL, very high cholesterol, and not being managed. There's also patients that are truly statin intolerant or don't want to take them. So the benefits of inclisiran are that it's an injection. You only have to give it once, then 3 months. And if the patient tolerates it, then every 6 months. So it's actually, you know, two injections a year to lower your cholesterol and your LDL. So we know that it's very effective. We know that it's safe from some of the safety studies we saw. So I've got 3 patients on it, and they were very keen to go on it. So I think it's a really good new agent to add to our sort of lipid arsenal, shall we say. There are the NICE guidelines, so the NICE TA733, which states that these patients have to have cardiovascular disease. So they either have stable coronary artery disease, or they've previously had an MI or an acute coronary syndrome or a stroke. They then have to have an LDL of over 2.6, either on taking maximal tolerated therapy, so that may be atorvastatin 80 or rosuvastatin plus ezetimibe, but we're also able to give it to patients with cardiovascular disease who are intolerant of statins, or who just don't want to take them, and that is an option for those patients. So they have to meet very strict criteria to be able to get onto inclisiran. Obviously, the efficacy of it, we know it reduces LDL by up to 50%. So if we can't get patients to target, my target for a patient with cardiovascular disease would definitely be an LDL of less than 1.8. And we know that the lower the LDL, the less likely they are to have a heart attack or a stroke or a cardiovascular event. So I think efficacy is important. It seems to be really well tolerated. It seems to be safe and actually convenient for patients. They only have to have it every 6 months. I've given 3 injections in the last month. Subcutaneous injection, very easy to administer. None of my patients have come back and said they've had any discomfort or any problem with it. So it really is very easy to order in and to give. We order it through a company called AAH. So most GP practices have an account with them because they supply us with all sorts of drugs that we administer. And this will be no different. So you can order it. It costs £45 per vial, but then there is a form to sign for Prescription Pricing Authority where we get £55 back. So the £10 sort of covers the overheads of giving it. So you're certainly not out of pocket. Got in the Northeast and North Cumbria some really good searches under the CDRC tool. So we've run those to identify patients who might be eligible for Inclisiran. And what we'll do is we'll initially review their notes, look to see if they're on optimal therapy. If not, we'll intensify that. If they are, then have a discussion with them about whether this is an option for them. So whether Inclisiran is an option. The searches are really quick. I guess the time is reviewing the notes and then bringing them in. But you know, in my opinion, it's something that's important to do because we know that if patients aren't a target or they're not taking statins to reduce their cardiovascular risk, they're at an increased risk. And last thing we want is patients having heart attacks, strokes, which may not only be fatal, but may mean going into hospital and then continuing healthcare costs, but continuing anxiety and stress to that patient and their family. So I think it's important work that we should be doing.